First of all, let me welcome all of you to this very important session. The Ministry of IT Government of India has constituted a working group for mass IT literacy for all. That is the name of that working group. And Dr. Murthy is looking after this particular thing in the ministry. And Indira Gandhi National Open University is chairing this IT mass literacy group. We had three or four very important focused meetings with the state secretaries of IT and also the private providers, the major private providers in IT in this country, and with Mr. Ravi Shankar and all the functionaries of the Ministry of IT. We have also identified a number of stakeholders who are going to do this work in a massive way. And very recently, I think it was on 15th, you know?
Last year.
Yeah, it was on 15th that we had a one-day brainstorming session. What are the type of activities which are necessary for popularizing the activities? In our country, we had successful missions of the usual literacy movements in the country, and we have also identified people from all sectors to propagate this particular activity, and there is no need of emphasizing the importance of IT literacy for an audience of this kind. Several civil society organizations are also going to be involved. Even now they are involved. And the purpose of this particular working group is to define IT literacy in a contextualized way. Maybe the IT literacy 15 years ago or 15 years ago, the present day definition could be totally different. And the Department of, what is the full form of DOEAC? DOEAC. Yeah, that department which is conducting large number of programs, approved programs in under the Ministry of IT, they are also major partners in this activity. But an activity of this kind to make the whole society IT literate, I think unconventional collaborations are necessary. It is very important that we spread the message to education institutions, maybe our library movements, then Janashikshan Sansthan under the Ministry of HRD. So there are large number of, I think Ministry of HRD is also one of the partners in this exercise. You know that with the broadband revolution, mobile revolution, and with the computer, the interventions of the computer, in all with different setups, it is becoming very, very diverse, and therefore we need to be focused. For this working group, our computer division, Indira Gandhi National Open University's computer division, is providing the necessary support. I think Dr. Srivastava, head computer division, is also sitting with us. This discussion which we are going to have, this dialogue which we are going to have, will provide, we expect that it will provide the necessary inputs for collaborating with each and every one of you for making this movement a successful one. And maybe we have to just look at the success stories of literacy and IT literacy happen in this country. I was telling in one of the meeting of the IT literacy group, mass IT literacy group, working group. I come from a state known as state Kerala, and there is a district known as Malappuram. I was working as a young lecturer in that university, Calicut University, several years ago. When the total literacy movement, not IT literacy movement, when the total literacy movement was mooted in the state of Kerala, of course, that was the first state to become 100% literate. In the total literacy movement, there was one district, the least, probably the maximum illiterate people were in one district known as Malappuram. It is between Kozhikode and Thrissur. It is towards the northern part of Kerala. That was the most illiterate, of course, illiterate numbers of people were not very high, but maximum illiterate people were in that district at that time. And then, of course, they became literate and all that. Then, after a few years, in Kerala, again, with the support of the Ministry of IT, Government of India, and State IT Department, they started the IT literacy movement, through Akshaya, they started. And surprisingly, this particular district where maximum conventional illiterates were there, this district was the first district in the country to become IT literate. The reason is again context. This particular district has a peculiarity. The life expectancy in Kerala is very high. There are a large number of old people, old parents, very old parents who are illiterate, but their children are working mostly in the Gulf countries, or particularly in Gulf countries. So they had to communicate with them. It was sort of a compulsion, and they learned how to make use of computer, how to make use of the internet, and they communicate with them, very, very old people. This was a success story. This was reported. Of course, I just mentioned about this thing. So therefore, the IT literacy has to be defined, contextualized, and we have to look at the diversity of levels of education in this country and the technological capabilities in terms of infrastructure. All these factors are going to be important. I don't want to make a speech. My job is only to chair the session and control this activity. We have around 75 minutes, maybe 10 minutes already over, 65 minutes. Each of the speaker can take 10 to 12 minutes. Probably we will leave more time for discussion, for them to participate in this exercise. Let me invite Mrs. Gulati. Mrs. Gulati, she is in the Ministry of Communication and Information Technology, Government of India. She is looking up the financial inclusion.
I am actually the Joint Administrator of Finance of the Universal Service Obligation.
Okay, Center. Okay. So let me invite her without any further thing. She has been introduced.